Hello, everyone. This is Cody Lee of BlackCatBooks.org, author of I, the Dragon, Cruel and Beautiful, Rabbit Hole, King Dale, Lord Frey, Grim Clover, and the upcoming Jaw the Dragon. And it is that time of year again where the fake leakers are rallying behind an obviously fake story to try and drum up interest to their Twitter accounts and their unrelated projects. This seems to be like a reoccurring thing. Like every couple of years, these people congregate and try very hard to push a story onto the Nintendo fan base that isn't really based in reality, typically regarding some upcoming game. Like a couple of years ago, it was Star Fox Grand Prix, and before that it was Pokemon Stars, before that it was, you know, Star Fox Zero conspiracies, Devil's Third conspiracies, like Endless Ocean 3 coming soon, Mother 3 coming out in 2015. Like, it's been a long 10-year cycle of just the same names over and over and over again coming out, presenting themselves as if they are reliable insiders at Nintendo, when we've seen time and time again that Nintendo takes active steps to prevent these kind of leaks from happening. Like, they simply do not happen. Ever. And to see Emily, right, to see, like, the fans on Reset Era, like, present this Toothpaste Chan, the new Fire Emblem, as being like, a confirmed new thing. Like, oh, man, like, Three Houses fans are going to get BTFO. It's really weird seeing how rabid the community is when it comes to defending these people, when they have nothing but a very, very long track record of being wrong about everything. And so I decided it was about time. Pretendo history, Emily Rogers. Like, what exactly, who is Emily Rogers? Where did she come from? What exactly is her circle? How exactly does she operate? I have been observing this individual and her nonsense for over a decade at this point. It goes back a long way. It might even go back further than what I'm aware of, because as we'll discuss shortly, Emily has a tendency to bounce from account to account, to bounce from community to community, probably to cover up her tracks. Because if you can go back and see some of the statements she's made over the years and see just how wrong she is about everything, like, remember when Mario Kart 8 Deluxe and Splatoon 2 didn't exist? Like, you'll see, anyone who will, like, actually go back and look at her actual leaks, it's either stuff we already know exists, right? Paper Mario Color Splash is probably a good example, where Intelligent Systems confirmed the game was coming at, like, a Japanese press conference, and Emily simply released the information when the Western gaming media weren't really aware of it, because they don't really have Japanese speakers to translate that kind of information over. Like, it wasn't something that Nintendo officially announced. It was just a confirmed at, like, a conference that, yes, like, a new Paper Mario is coming. Like, okay, so typically what happens is that every time that people are eagerly anticipating a major Nintendo announcement, typically, like, around June, typically, like, right before E3, Emily Rogers makes some vague claim regarding, like, the future of Nintendo software, or when it comes to a next-gen platform, like, upcoming software details. So in 2011, the earliest I've seen from her, she released statements, like, talking about, like, Endless Ocean 3 coming to Wii U and Soul Calibur 5 being, like, developed as a Wii U exclusive and stuff like that. And it was reported on by the gaming media as, like, some serious thing, like, serious investigative sleuthing on the part of Emily Rogers. But those the information she released was not true. Like, we did get a Pikmin 3, like she said we were going to get, but like I mentioned earlier, Nintendo basically confirmed we were getting a new Pikmin game anyway. So it's wasn't really that spectacular of an insider information to predict that, oh, someday Pikmin 3 is going to come out. Like, it wasn't that big of a deal. And so, like, we over the past couple over the next couple of years, we've seen this weird sort of trend where Emily will release some vague statements in regards to upcoming Nintendo games. Like, Mother 3 is coming soon. It's probably the most infamous one. Like, there was a big period in like 2015 and 2016 where she was like saying that all the time. It's definitely coming soon, guys. Stuff like Star Fox Grand Prix, right, where she and a bunch of other leakers were fooled by a fan-made logo design change where they took the design for Star Fox Guard and changed it to Star Fox Grand Prix. Like, again, these guys have a long history of being wrong about the inside about like what's going on at Nintendo, and they always try to spin it. They always try to say that, like, oh yeah, projects get canceled, plans change, Nintendo canceled projects because of the leaks. Like, you keep hearing things like this over and over and over again. If, like, whenever they get put in a position where they kind of have to acknowledge that they're making it all up, that they don't actually have insider sources at Nintendo, right? Because again, the sources would be rooted out and dealt with if they did exist, but they haven't. In fact, one of the interesting things I've noticed over the years, Nintendo hasn't really gone after Emily Rogers at all. And the reason for that is because she's never actually revealed anything. Like, she's just some nobody with a Twitter account who, for some inexplicable reason, has a bunch of moderators on Reset Era giving credence that she's some like reliable insider. Like, you have a bunch of these no-name personalities, people like Laura Kate Dale, people like Liam Robertson, people like Stealth4K, people like Arlo, I think, buys into this kind of stuff. Like, you have people like that who report on every single like tweet she makes as if it's like fact. It's a weird way to kind of create this alternative gaming news cycle where mainstream outlets won't really report on these rumors because they don't really need to. It's not really their thing. By using Emily Rogers, a lot of these smaller sites, like a lot, particularly these like smaller Nintendo-focused ones, a lot of these smaller YouTube channels, they have a source of content. By blindly believing Emily Rogers and reporting on it as her statements as if they are fact, they have a source of content that nobody else is going to touch because nobody outside of a very specific demographic of people who are so desperate for new Nintendo news that they'll believe what Emily Rogers tells them will click on their content. So it's this thing where it's this very nobody involved in the situation really wants to admit that Emily Rogers is making it all up because she gets clicks, like she gets attention for these YouTube channels, for these websites that they otherwise would not be able to get. And we're kind of seeing that now with Fire Emblem. It's weird to see people like spamming Toothpaste Chan, as she's known, on image boards, like drawing fan art of her, like really trying to force this idea that like this is a thing that really exists, that people are buying into it. No, it feels like a small handful of people are desperately trying to like make this the talked about thing. So to drive traffic to their videos where they talk about it more openly. I being a Fire Emblem fan myself, like looking at like the released images, like I don't believe they're real. I'm almost certain they aren't. I mean, I could hypothetically be wrong about that, but at the same time, it's there are too many red flags, right? The timing is weird. The people involved are unreliable, proven to be unreliable, and like, there's just a long, long history of this kind of thing happening over and over and over again. And I think gamers really need to really stop supporting these kind of rumors. Like, I myself have distanced my channel from anyone who would like believe in this stuff or talk about it. It's not really something I want to hear about or care for because, again, like I've seen these stories just kind of implode over the years. Like again, remember Pokemon Stars? Remember Star Fox Grand Prix? Like that wasn't that long ago, honestly. Remember the Switch Pro? Like it's the same thing coming from the same people over and over and over again. And it is high time that Nintendo fans stop believing their lies.